NGA. We're gonna learn it from NGA. She's a robot from Sweet. We're gonna learn it from NGA.
That's me. Welcome to Engineering Expo. Well, what are you waiting for? Let's go.
Hi, I'm Michelle. I'm a civil engineer working as an estimator at Sillison & Sons, and I'm a member of the Expo Committee. Today I have my friend with me.
Hi, I'm Deana, and I'm a retired professional college engineering recruiter, and I am also a member of Expo.
Today we are going to build homopolar motors. Here are the materials you will need.
Michelle, what is a homopolar motor?
Deana, a homopolar motor is a simple motor. Today we're going to use a battery, some strong magnets, and a copper wire to make a tiny dancer, which is a homopolar motor. So the current will flow out of the positive end of the battery, through our copper wire, through the loop around the magnets at the bottom, and the current will flow back through the magnets and into the battery again. And that current is what makes our tiny dancer spin around.
Wow, that sounds like fun. Can we do one?
Of course.
Okay.
All right, Deana, to get started making our tiny dancer homopolar motors, we're going to start with copper wire. This one's about 10 inches long, and we're using insulated copper wire. If you're using the same, you want to make sure that your ends are stripped. And this is something that an adult can help you do. If you have bare wire, you can skip this step. We'll each need a set of strong magnets and a AA battery.
Okay.
So when we get started building our tiny dancer, the first thing we want to do is to make sure that we build a loop at the bottom. This is to go around the magnets. You want to make sure that your loop is big enough to fit around the magnets, but not too big that it's really far away. The next step is to make sure that your tiny dancer is as tall as your battery. We want to make sure to be on top of the battery. Mm-hmm. After that, we will design our tiny dancer. You want to make sure that your dancer is symmetrical so it doesn't fall over. And then our final step is our end of the copper wire that needs to touch the top of the battery when we're done.
Okay. That sounds fun. I think I'm going to try to make an airplane.
Ooh, that sounds like it'll be awesome. Let's get started.
Okay. Michelle, that was really difficult.
I agree.
Yeah, I had problems with this down here, making it a circle so it'd go around there and not touch it. And then, as you can see, it's not an airplane. I couldn't make an airplane, so I now have a hot air balloon.
I still like it a lot, Deana.
Good, thanks.
I know I had trouble getting mine the right height. I even, you know, measured it out beforehand, and I had to make some adjustments.
Uh-huh.
And then I definitely had trouble with getting it to balance. My dancer kind of liked to lean over
a little bit.
But
it looks good.
Thanks. I think now that we have them working, do you want to decorate them?
Okay, sounds good.
All right.
What tissue paper do you want?
I'm all about sparkles.
Okay, sounds great.
We made tiny dancers.
Oh, and mine was a hot air balloon.
Using homopolar motors.
And I found out something. What you do is when you put your little ornament, whatever you make, a dancer or hot air balloon or whatever, on your battery, the current flow goes up through, touches this wire right here, goes around, down, and then hits this magnet down here and starts the flow back again.
That's right, Deana.
Good.
When we were making our homopolar motors, we actually ran into a couple of issues along the way.
Mm-hmm.
And that's okay. Engineers often run into problems when they are working on things, but they use their problem-solving skills to work through it and get their item to work. So here are some of the problems we ran into when building ours and some ways we work through how to fix them. Homopolar motors are useful because of their simplicity. Current flows in one direction, and they have less moving parts. Using your engineering notebook, can you think or research ways homopolar motors are used in the real world?
Can you think of other types of motors and what they are used for? Thank you for dancing with us.
If you build your own homopolar motor, take a video or a picture and share it to our Facebook event page for a chance to win a prize.
Until then,
see you next time.
That's me. Thanks for joining us today. See you next time.